you have a plan to increase security in places like that?
The district has up-to-date and well-tested emergency response plans.
Full second speed Jackson! Tiger Alpha!
This program was produced by Lenape District Television.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Seneca High School for today's boys basketball matchup between the Shawnee Renegades and the Seneca Golden Eagles. I'm Jimmy Freese here along with Scott Gloucester. Scott, what can we expect from today's game?
Well, it's going to be a tough one for Seneca tonight. Shawnee 15-2, coming off only their second loss Tuesday at Lenape. Seneca playing much better, not 7-11. They're going to have to play their best game of the year. Let's sit back. On paper, it looks like Shawnee should have a pretty easy time tonight. On the court, could be completely different here on LDTV.
All right, Scott, we'll see if you're right when we're back for tip-off.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990, www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market, all the best, all right here. 215-336-3003, www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Wilmore School of Gymnastics and Cheer, where every child is special. Located on Briggs Road in Mount Laurel. 856-234-5292. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward, please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads-up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680, or by email, jmalagrana@lrhsd.org.
And we are back here, ladies and gentlemen, at Seneca High School in preparation for this boys basketball matchup.
Big crowd here tonight, Jimmy. Youth night here. Two sister schools less than 5 miles apart. A lot of fans from both sides. Quite an atmosphere that you don't find here a lot at Seneca for basketball or any winter sport. This is exciting.
And it's now time for the AXA Equitable Keys to the Game, providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, be life confident at 732-452-7275. All right, Scott, so Shawnee wants to control the boards.
Okay, Shawnee wants to get rebounds, obviously. You control the boards, miss shots on the offensive end, get put back on the defensive end, you start to break down.
Seneca wants to maintain poise and their composure.
Yeah, Shawnee's got a very difficult defense, and if they get up into the face of Seneca, who's got less experience, it could not go well for their Golden Eagles.
And both teams want to have a solid team defense, as we see our AXA Equitable Keys of the Game on the screen here.
Solid team defense without committing fouls. Too many fouls puts the other team in the bonus, could swing the game one way or the other.
All right, Scott, thank you, and thank you, AXA Equitable, for the keys to the game.
And there he is, Coach Joe Kessler. You see him on the screen, Jimmy. Over 600 wins right there for Coach K.
In his 30th year with the team.
Amazing.
So it's complete loyalty. And we're going to look over. It's that time for the AXA Equitable Sideline Report, providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, be life confident at 732-452-7275. And now let's send it over to John Conlow with the report.
Thanks, guys. Today I talked to Shawnee head coach Kenneman, and he said the team plays hard, but they need to get more rebounds on offense. He said they are playing an excellent team, and they're going to have to be very competitive. He said today players to watch are Jay Crockett, Mike Ginyard, and J.J. Scarpello. If these three do well, the team will win. I also talked to Shawnee head coach Kessler, and he said they have young experience, but the players are very well, and they need to get rebounds a lot better. Today, players to watch are Dean Knoll, Dylan Davini, and Devon Robinson. This is going to be a good game to watch. Let's see what happens. I'm here on the court. Back to you guys.
All right, John. You see our matchup on the screen here. It's going to be the 15-2 Shawnee Renegades and the Seneca 7-11 Seneca Golden Eagles. We're going to see the tip-off when we return here on LDTV.
Connect with the Lenape Regional High School District Highlights page on Facebook to see outstanding achievements of our students and staff. Just type LRHSD Highlights, hit like, and you'll get the latest updates on achievements in academics, extracurricular activities, community service, and athletics from all four of the Lenape District's high schools. From success in the classroom, to volunteering in the community, to milestones on the court, there's a lot to like with the Lenape Regional High School District Highlights page.
And ladies and gentlemen, we are back for the beginning of this basketball game. Just had a beautiful rendition of the national anthem.
Sarah Hahn, she's amazing, amazing.
And as Scott announced to the crowd, tonight we have our starters for Shawnee out on the court. Players to watch for, definitely Devon Robinson for Shawnee and Nyjie Kinlaw for Seneca. Devon Robinson waits at midcourt for Seneca Golden Eagles. Scott, it feels there's a feeling in here.
There is. There's an atmosphere tonight. I don't know how well. I don't know what the final result's going to be, but what a beginning. Hats off to Coach Kenevin for honoring the youth. Jimmy Freeze, take it away, play-by-play.
And Pat Kernan going to look at an open jump shot. Going to miss that early one. Devon Robinson's got the rebound. Robinson from the corner. Going to go in and out.
Talked about rebounding, Jimmy, already three right. Tries this time down for the Renegades.
Devaney's got a three, not going to get it.
Solid rebound by Ginyard. Three attempts, though. You don't see Shawnee miss three shots very often.
That's going to be Jack Brockett bringing it down. Passing it over to Scarpello. Hine playing on Scarpello. Ginyard gives it to Brockett for the shot, going to miss it. And Dean Knoll gonna bring it down for the Shawnee Renegades, a big leader for that Renegade team.
Nice move.
Knoll
nice
gets
pass.
It down low, easy two. Nice pass from Devaney for the first points of the game for Shawnee. Jack Brockett gonna bring it down, pass it over to Ginyard. Ginyard drives, hits it to Kay for that couple foot jumper, not gonna get it. Dean Knoll's gonna bring it down. Devaney over to Kernan. Ginyard playing on him. Dean Knoll with a nice little move. Passes it to Kernan. Devaney Davon Robinson down low. Knoll with the jumper. Nice two there from Dean Knoll. That's his second two of the game. 4 points for him. Jack Brockett going to bring it down. Brockett gives it to Ginyard.
Sorry, Jack.
It's okay.
Jimmy. Now here's where the Golden Eagles have to show some poise on offense. Down four, nothing big yet.
Scarpello gives it back to Brockett.
They could use a basket here.
Nice steal from Davon Robinson. He'll drive in, get the two and one. Nygie Kinlaw on the foul.
Nice job by Davon Robinson to protect the ball with his left hand when he went up there. Nygie Kinlaw had to try to commit the foul and possibly stop the basket, but good power move by Davon Robinson to the hoop there. Wouldn't be surprised to see Coach Kenevan, if he makes this free throw, take a quick timeout just to settle his guys down a little bit. Because if he makes this, they're going to be down seven early.
And Robinson will get the three-point play. So Jack Brockett's going to bring it down. Seneca still looking for those first 2 points. Ginyard up top. Brockett on the side, giving Kay an order. And a three-second violation
on Nygie Kinlaw, so that'll be another turnover for the Golden Eagles.
It's obviously still very early, Scott, but it's gotten a lot quieter
in
this gym. And Patrick Kernan, pass to DeVenny. Right across, nice play by Walter Kay. DeVenny still gets it. It's for Hine. Hine's in the corner.
Ball goes through the hands of Scarpello. Would have been a nice steal.
And Scarpello with a nice hit, but DeVenny again saves it for Shawnee.
I think if you asked J.J. Scarpello, should he have caught that ball, would have been absolutely 100% yes. Allowed Shawnee to keep possession. That could have been a big turnover.
Dean Knoll gives it to DeVenny. DeVenny for three. Short there, not going to get it. Rebound by Patrick Kernan.
Another offensive rebound.
Gives it to Robinson. Three for Hine. He's got it. Nails the tray.
And there comes the timeout that I thought we'd see at 7-0 and waited till another three-pointer at 10. Worst-case scenario start for Seneca. Mm-hmm. Worst case. For Coach Ketzler, good start, no question about it. I think he'd be a little upset that they missed so many shots,
right,
but they've gotten every offensive rebound, and we talked about that in the beginning. If this continues at this pace with Shawnee.
And we're going to take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Online at ivyrehab.com. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy.
That's the three by DeVinny. Another miss, and then the offensive rebound again.
Yeah.
Good play by Kernan, who goes to Robinson. Great kick out back to DeVinny at the three-point line, and he knocks it down. It's unselfish. You know, Davon Robinson there has probably got a good look to power up to the basket, and he kicks it out to the open man. Characteristic of Coach Kessler's team. Very unselfish. Look for the better shot at all times. But anyway, if the offensive rebounding, if Seneca doesn't do something on the defensive rebounding end, this could get really out of hand quickly. Mm-hmm. So,
see the same gentleman on the court for each team.
One thing about the Golden Eagles, though, they will not quit. They'll make their run.
So Jack Brockett's going to bring it down. Patrick Kernan waiting for him. Passes it to Ginyard.
Jack Brockett might have the best looking shoes we've seen on LDTV this year.
That might be right, Scott.
Gonna get a foul.
We'll get Patrick Kernan on the first foul for Shawnee. And Seneca's gonna look to break that golden eagle loose egg.
First team foul, zero. First personal foul. Brockett to the line to shoot a pair.
Brockett will miss his first. Number 11, Jack Brockett, the junior, looking for at least 1 point here from his foul shot. And Brockett will make his first.
Golden Eagles on the board.
So Brockett 1-for-2 on free throws. 10-1 with 4:09 remaining in the first quarter. Dean Knoll over to Kernan. Kernan to Robinson. Robinson will throw right in the arms of Ginyard.
Yeah, and Hine wanted to pass, skip pass across the top, but didn't get it.
Brockett gives it to Nyjie Kinlaw. Brockett up top. Brockett for three. Not going to get it. Dean Knoll looking for a fast break.
Seneca nice back on defense. Three guys back.
Oh, DeVinny drives.
The big man. Can't get it to go, though. Nice rebound by Walter Kay. It's a good move by DeVinny. Just couldn't get it to fall.
Brockett. He will drive. Kick it out to Ginyard. That was three. He's got it. And Michael Ginyard makes the first from the field for Seneca. Patrick Kernan. Knoll drives.
Oh, nice left-hand move, but again couldn't get it to fall. A couple of nice drives back two times, last two times down for the Renegades, but they couldn't get it to fall. Ginyard to the basket.
Nothing.
And he can't get it to go.
Right. Davon to DeVinny. DeVinny for three. He's got the tray.
Yeah, you can't leave him open out there. That's his second three.
So here's Jack Brockett. Gives it to
Ginyard.
Huge
turnaround there, Jimmy. If Seneca makes the basket.
Kay right under the basket, he'll get the easy two.
If that basket by Ginyard goes down and Shawnee doesn't get the three, you know, we'd have a 10-6 game. Good recovery by the Golden Eagles, though, to get a basket back. Walter Kay, nice inside position, finished strong.
Robinson from the corner. Looking for a pass to DeVinny. Little off. Nicely played by Jack Brockett, who has the ball now. He's going to bring it down. Brockett drives. And Davon Robinson with the rebound. Robinson, nice pass over to Kernan. No-look pass. Robinson, terrific passing from Davon
Robinson.
He's going
to shoot that. Oh, I'm surprised.
DeVinny gives it to Knoll. Knoll's got the open three. Not going to get that.
Oh, Hine, great right rebound by Hine. Another offensive rebound by the Renegades.
Sean Hine right out of the basket.
I'm not keeping track of that, but that's got to be 5 or 6 already in terms of offensive rebounds.
Some say if you're not getting the pass, get under the basket for the rebound. That's what he did. Got the easy two. Scarpello airballs that one.
A little far out of the range for JJ, I think.
Davon Robinson.
Oh, right great underneath
Dean
pass.
Knoll,
a great look.
Dean Knoll, terrific. That's a slide under.
That's a big man making a pass like that. You don't see that often.
What's so dynamic about this Shawnee basketball team, Scott, is every guy brings a different aspect, but they can all do the normal, you know, basketball dynamics. It's unbelievable to see at just the high school level.
Oh, excellent fundamentals. You know, not only do they come with them, but Coach Kessler, you know, you don't have the success that Coach K's had for 30 years and not teach the fundamentals and have your players execute the fundamentals.
So we're going to see Davon Robinson take a breather. In for him is Kane Feutner. So Dean Knoll gives it over to Kernan.
I don't know if they intended to, but I'm guessing at this point the Renegades are going to hold for one. They had 30 seconds.
So we see 10 seconds remain in our first quarter.
Solid defense by the Golden Eagles.
Oh,
nice solid move.
That should cap off the first quarter, and it does. Here at Seneca High School, with the end of the first quarter, score being Shawnee 19, Seneca 6.
Looking at Coach Kessler's huddle there, he's got to be very, very happy, especially from the offensive rebounding side. The big man there with a powerful drive, couple nice passes by Davon Robinson and by Dylan Devaney. Golden Eagles have not gotten on track. Let's just leave it at that. But they're playing against one of the premier teams in South Jersey. So,
how do they get back on track?
Well, it's a good question. Shawnee got good ball movement, so you got to play a little tighter defense, deny the passes. I think they're forcing up a lot of three-pointers from longer range than what I've seen them play before. Be more patient on offense. Move the ball around.
You're rotate. Seeing a lot of passing, a lot of assists with Shawnee.
Right. Maybe rotate the ball, swing it around the perimeter, you know, till you find that open guy. Just a little too quick on offense, I think, for Seneca tonight.
How much does it help, you know, falling behind so early? Does it help that much to imitate what the other team is doing, maybe?
Well, I'm not sure you can. You know, you got a whole different personnel set on the Seneca side. I think Coach Kenevan just got to go back to what has worked recently. You know, they had a three-game winning streak there in the middle of the season about 4 games ago. They've won 3 of their last 4, I believe. I just think you got to go back to what has worked for you in the past 4 or 5 games where you've won the majority of your games. And that has been patience. And they don't look as patient as they probably should on offense tonight. And Shawnee pressures that. I mean, you know, you know, you're a district student. You know what this rivalry means to both of these teams.
Yep.
You know, 3 or 4 miles up, you know, Medford Lakes Tabernacle Road. This has been a rivalry that since Seneca was born, you know, 14 years ago, that's been pretty intense in most all sports.
All right, so we're back for the second quarter here. Up top is going to be Kinlaw. Over to Brockett, in for Seneca, Thomas Jensen.
Very good. Tom Jensen checks in.
He's going to be in for Walter Kay. As we see Ginyard up top, give it to J.J. Scarpello. To Brockett. Brockett looks to drive. Nice defense by Devaney and the rim. And a rebound by Kane Futner to Dean Knoll. Dean Knoll kicks it out to Hine. Futner's up top. And also in for Shawnee's going to be Robbie Steffen, the senior. So Knoll gives it to Steffen. Steffen will drive, and he'll get the and one. Steffen's first 2 of the night.
Jack Brockett's going to get the personal foul. Second team foul, first personal foul on Brockett. Robbie Steffen to go to the line to try to make the conventional three-point play. Davon Robinson checking back in, as is Pat Kernan. Giving Hine and Knoll a bit of a breather.
So Steffen will complete the three-point play.
It's a nice roll. Looked like it was going to be a little short. Good rotation on that shot.
Brockett gives it to Jensen. Jensen to Ginyard. Jensen in the corner to Kinlaw. And back up top to Brockett. Brockett drives. Looks like it was off of Dylan Devaney.
Yeah, they had it. He stripped it nicely, actually, without getting a reach-in foul. Just isn't much open for Seneca. You notice that. Shawnee defense is really, really, you know, we talked about in the opener about the tough defense, and, you know, Shawnee's playing incredibly tough defense, and they're finding the open man on the offense. Yeah.
Is that something that increases over time, or first day of the season, Coach Kessler's like defense right away?
Oh, I think he absolutely defense right away. I think he realizes and knows after being around all those years that defense is going to ultimately win. Maybe not so much regular season, although it does, obviously. But you get postseason where we're only, what, a couple weeks away from postseason,
right.
3 weeks maybe. You're going to have to play some defense. And that's what's unselfish about the Renegades is they're willing to play defense too. They can win a high-scoring game or a low-scoring game.
Yep. We see Kernan up top. Gives it to Devaney. To Davon Robinson. Fakes the 3. Passes to Kane Futner. Back to Robinson.
Oh, nice
passing. Robbie Steffen's not going to get that.
A tough shot.
Highly
there.
Contested shot, yes.
Yeah, it's good defense there. Didn't break down.
Scarpello looks to drive. Nice little spin. Not going to get that. Rebound by Robinson.
Those are tough shots, though. Shawnee's making them, you know, nothing's easy.
Robinson, nice pass to DeVenny. DeVenny has trouble handling. He gets it. Kernan from the key. Won't get that. And a rebound by Brockett. Brockett drives. Hit by the backboard.
Yeah, rejected, though, by DeVenny, too. Made him alter his shot. Oh, it opens three.
Three. He's got the tray.
That's his third three-pointer of the game so far. And now Shawnee's lead is increased to 19. Seneca timeout.
Nice shot from Dylan DeVenny.
Look into the huddle of
Let's Seneca. Take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
There it again, another kick out, and there's, you
wide
know,
open.
Everybody collapsing down on the ball, and you gotta know where he is, because as a big man, and that's a big that's a great asset to be able to power down low like we've seen him do a couple times. But that's his third three-pointer. That's a what do you call it? All-purpose weapon, if you will.
Right.
You know, he can go all over the court. He can be under the basket. He can be out beyond the three-point line. Makes him very tough to defend. If you come out on him, then he's a good passer. We saw that already. So, Dylan DeVenny's got a lot of skill, as if you didn't notice that already.
Going to see Jack Brockett bring it down, goes to Ginyard.
Nice give and go with Nigel Kinlaw.
Kinlaw right from the corner.
Can't get it
key.
To fall.
Stefan will bring it down to Davon Robinson. Robinson, nice pass. Maybe a little too hard for Kernan's liking.
I think that'll be a trip on Feudner.
It's Feudner's first of the day.
Second team foul. Neither team in very much danger of getting into the penalty with only a pair of team fouls on each side, and we're 4 3/4 minutes to go in half number one.
Coming back for Shawnee is going to be Sean Hine and Dean Knoll. And Travis the Gronk Garasino.
I'm sure Jimmy will enlighten us as to that nickname.
He's got quite the mantra of Rob Gronkowski.
Okay.
His friends call him that. We see up top Jack Brockett with a long three. Not gonna get it. Davon Robinson. Gives it to Kernan. Kernan up top. Davon Robinson for three. A little short.
The other thing about rebounding is I can't remember so far of a second chance bucket for the Golden Eagles yet.
Yep. Oh, defensive and offensive rebounds being controlled by Shawnee.
We might get one here as Sean Hine accidentally couldn't corral. It was a little too high for him and hit off his hand and tipped out of bounds. So a second chance opportunity for the Golden Eagles.
Knoll playing nice defense. Kinlaw gives it to Ginyard. Over to Kinlaw. Back to Scarpello. In the corner, that's Jeanson.
Not much movement on offense, if you notice. And you know,
Brockett will drive. There's a rebound by Kinlaw, and he calls a timeout. So the first rebound, they got it. Called a timeout.
That's a good heads-up play by Nigel Kinlaw, knowing he's going to get called for a travel if he didn't get the timeout.
So as we see our score here, Shawnee's leading Seneca 25-6 with 3:32 left in the second quarter.
Interesting, Shawnee coach Kenevan, you see them in the middle of the huddle, 8 years as the girls basketball coach and now his first year as the boys basketball coach. I actually work in the same department with them, and it's a different dynamic coaching boys and girls. And you probably see, there they are, I was just going to say, maybe in the background you can see the Seneca pep band joining us here for this game tonight. It's a more common occurrence at Lenape, but it's getting more and more common here at Seneca. It's nice of Mr. Doug Barber, who's in charge of the pep band, and great for the kids. So how about those kids giving up their
Absolutely.
Free time at night to come back and help cheer on their...
Brings together the sports and the music aspect of the school. It shows how important both organizations are here at Seneca High School.
And the whole school. Nice strip. Oh, and another nice strip. Couple
Matt Kernan
nice
will drive. Jeanson playing on him. And that was a highly contested shot. Tough
Jeanson did a nice job with his body without fouling, but Nigel Kinlaw was there kind of to make that shot. Oh, and there's a turnover, but a nice catch by Coach Giller. Still got them quick hands.
So we'll see Shawnee ball. Sean Hine is going to give it to Dean Knoll.
Series of turnovers there in these last couple possessions.
Right.
By both squads.
Kernan gives it to Travis Garasino. Devon Robinson over to the Gronk. Gives it to Pat Kernan. Dean Knoll to Devon. Nice move by Dean Knoll. Kicks it out. Kernan to Garasino for three. Not going to get it. Dean Knoll, nice rebound. Put it right back in. Isn't going to get it, though. Rebound by Jeanson. And ends up in the hands of Brockett.
The other thing I noticed is Shawnee doesn't have a player that won't shoot a three.
Right.
Pretty much.
Brockett with Kernan. Brockett for three. Nope. Robinson with the rebound. Goes to Knoll. Robinson to Kernan. Kernan will drive.
Oh, nice move. Are they going to get him for a travel? Yep.
Oh, yes, they will. Back in the game is going to be Dylan DeVenny. Taking Luke, out Travis Garasino.
And Luke Hoey checks in for the Golden Eagles, replacing J.J. Scarpello along with Dane Kane. Coming in for Seneca.
And Chris McCauley, number four. Boatload of new faces for the Seneca Golden Eagles. See if they can change it up and get back from this 19-point deficit. So Chris McCauley's going to bring it down. Chris McCauley with a fast head of steam. Jeanson right under the basket. Gets rejected by Knoll, but also fouled. That is going to be on Dean Knoll. That's his first foul of the game. Jeanson will try. It'll be his first free throw attempt.
Well, Jeanson misses the first and misses the second.
Yep. Rebound by Devon Robinson. Dean Knoll brings it down. Chris McCauley playing tough on defense.
Oh, nice backdoor.
Oh, Kernan will get right in, yeah. Dan Kane took the bait that Devon Robinson gave him. And
another pass by a big man, though. You know, you don't think of Devon Robinson as being a play, as a...
Oh. Dan Kane will take the three and nail the tray.
There you go. First points for the Golden Eagles this quarter.
Wow. Dean Knoll to Hine, to Kernan, to Robinson. Oh, very fast passing.
I thought Hine was going to shoot that one.
Kernan goes to Knoll. DeVenny, going to get that jumper.
Oh, great nice. Offensive rebound.
Dean Knoll gets the easy two, but not very easy. Had to push the basket there. Rush the paint, get the two. Puts Shawnee back up by 20 points. Biggest lead of the night.
Nyjie Kinlaw, the only starter back and still in the lineup for Seneca now. And there's another Golden Eagle turnover. Oh, Robinson, three on one.
DeVenny, nice. Wow.
Great body control.
Wow.
Great yep. body control there.
Quite the show being put on here by Shawnee Renegades. And DeVenny will reject
Luke Hoey.
Right at the other end, Dean Knoll will get two and
he's
get
score.
Fouled. Look for the end one. As 3 seconds remain. Here in the second quarter.
Fouls on Jeanson. Oh, no, on Nyjie Kinlaw, maybe? Yeah, Nyjie Kinlaw, his second, third team foul. Dean Knoll looking to make it an and one, and does.
Yep.
And increasing the Renegade lead to 25 with just 3 seconds to go. And McCauley's shot is rejected, and that's going to be, oh.
Close for Robinson. Not going to get it. That's going to be the score at the end of the first half with Shawnee up 34-9 here at Seneca High School. Quite the dominating half.
Yeah.
For
offensively,
everybody.
Defensively.
Everybody on Shawnee's providing.
They have been.
Bringing
home the
bacon.
You can see why they're 15-2 and ranked number 5 in South Jersey. And as I thought might happen, and I said this in the beginning, I'm sure there was a little extra work at practice yesterday for the boys down the road in Medford after that loss to Lenape on Tuesday night.
You're saying it definitely worked, though. Whatever Coach K did definitely worked here for Shawnee. So far, still early. Great half by Davon Robinson, Dean Knoll, Dylan Deveni. List goes on and on. But Seneca on the other side. Michael Ginyard's playing well. And Walter Kay. Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
Oh, that last move, real nice. Again, you know, that's smart basketball. He's keeping the ball out here so the block can't happen. If the ball goes, great. If it's not, he's going to have two shots.
And that's going to be our score at halftime, 34-9 with Shawnee over the Seneca Golden Eagles. And we will be back for the second half.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990, www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market, all the best, all right here. 215-336-3003, or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Wilmore School of Gymnastics and Cheer, where every child is special. Located on Briggs Road in Mount Laurel, 856-234-5292. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward. Please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads-up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680, or by email, jmalagrana@lrhsd.org.
Hey, son.
So, you're turning 13, becoming a man. Your hormones are surging, starting to notice the girls. You know, maybe your body's doing some funny things. So, you want to talk? Or we could talk about drugs.
Yeah, let's talk about drugs.
There's no wrong way to talk to your kids about drugs, but you'll need to be ready. We can help. Visit our website at drugfree.org.
And we are back here at Seneca High School. We're a little different here at LDTV Sports. We're going to be showing a skills challenge here for the youth community for the Seneca Golden Eagles. And what they're going to have to do is our buddy Scott Glossner is going to announce to the crowd. But each child is going to have to put on a jersey as quick as they can, run to half court, put up some shots, or put on shorts. They're going to get a ball, dribble it to half court, and then they're going to score. So the first, there's three kids on each side, and whoever does it first, you get the prize. Every child here is going to win a Seneca t-shirt, thanks to the giving folks here at Seneca High School, showing that it doesn't really matter if you win or lose, you always, as long as you try, that's what's important. As Scott gives us our rules. He's broadcasting to the crowd, pretty much going at half court. Situation here, Seneca losing here 9-34. As we can talk about the game a little bit, just terrific work by the big men of Shawnee High School. That's all we can talk about. Everybody on this Shawnee team brings a different dynamic, as we said, but they all have the basic fundamentals to carry a team. That's unbelievable to see. As I said, in the high school level, you see that start to develop at the college level, maybe even the NBA. But showing that in the high school level is unbelievable, and Coach Kessler deserves all the credit he gets. As we see on the other side, though, Sean Kenevan, he's got to talk to his guys in the locker room as we see our skills challenge. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Most entertaining part of the night as they're putting on the jerseys. Getting a little help here. Who are we going to cheer for? Oh, it looks like we have one early leader, number 34. He's going to bring it down. I'm feeling number 34. He's getting the shorts on early. A little late. He's got the ball already, number 34. He seems to be the favorite tonight. Number 34 nails the easy layup. Oh, they're all number 34. Oh, maybe not. Oh, they're all different numbers. Green, 34, made his shot. And there's number Green, 11. He'll get it. And Green, 14, he's having a little trouble. And looks like white, number 11, doesn't really know that his jersey's on backwards, but that's okay. Number 14, not gonna get it. It's okay. Maybe staying after with little Coach Kessler. He's shaking his head. He doesn't want it. No, he says no. He tried. Our winner's going to be announced soon. Taking their jerseys off. They had the pride to rock the Seneca outfit for a little bit. Nice job by Green, 34. And both teams being called to the announcer's table. Be greeted by Scott. He sounds like he's got a gift for him or something like that. Logan with the win. He's going to win a gift card. He in there. Oh, Ethan. Scott having a little trouble with that, but that's okay here at Seneca High School. It's always a good time here on LDTV. Team, the white team won. Terrific matchup. The green team tried very hard, but the white team gets the W. It's gonna be our next challenge here is going to be the minute to win it. Now, the children are going to have to make a layup, free throw, three-pointer, and a half-court shot all in 1 minute. Can somebody do it? We're gonna have to see. I sure as heck could not, but it'll be entertaining to see our Seneca youth go for it and try this tough matchup. As we see a winner here, he's got the Sixers tickets. He's gonna be trusting the process. Oh, he's actually a Cubs fan. Well, that was a special year for him. Team led by Jake Arrieta. Biggest shock of probably the century. Going against Billy the Goat as the Chicago Cubs won the World Series. See our Shawnee team returning from the locker room. Imagine Coach Kessler didn't need to give him that much of a pep talk. Probably just said, keep your head in it. Keep the pedal to the metal.
And Zach over here.
All right.
Here are the rules. When you hear the buzzer sound, you will shoot a layup, then a free throw, then a three-pointer. Lastly, a half-court shot.
Right, there's
you have 1 minute to do this. For participating, each of you receives a Seneca basketball t-shirt. The first person to complete the challenge wins. The tiebreaker will be the first one to make a free throw. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
So we have the Cubbies fan here against Mr. Platt. Cubbies fan is up to an early lead. All right, Mr. Platt is still waiting on that layup. He's got it. Cubbies fan. Both missing here, having trouble at free throw line. And there's the Cubbies fan. He'll nail the free throw. Looking for the three.
Whoever gets
banks the tray.
Like neither one of them are going to make it.
Cubbies fan looking for the half court. Nothing. He's got some time though. Mr. Plaid still working on that free throw. He'll bank it, sure. He's going to go for the tray. Cubbies fans waiting. Oh, Mr. Plaid takes a side three-pointer. He's going all over the place, looking like Kyle Korver. Hey, not getting it there. Still waiting on that Cubbies fan. 2-1. Nothing. Both guys having trouble, but a terrific matchup between Mr. Cubbies fan and Mr. Platt.
Gage was the only one to make the three-pointer. Gage wins a $10 Wawa gift card.
Whoa, $10 Wawa gift card for the Cubbies fan.
All right, last but not least, is this the Sixers?
You get to hear Scott and his discussion.
Where's Kenevan?
Oh, there you go.
We have one last prize. Last but not least, you got to turn that down.
Scott giving his orders.
What ticket?
And there's the Seneca cheerleaders throwing out the t-shirts to the fans.
Okay, here we go.
Fans loving it.
Our last
Phillies games, they do the
evening.
Hot dogs. Maybe that's a little
Listen
gross.
Up.
I'd rather the t-shirt.
I know, but they want to get started.
Hurry up.
Adults,
here
high
we
school
go.
Kids, two tickets to a Sixers game.
See Scott in that beautifully colored shirt.
7583.
He's got it.
What's his name? I never have.
Scott announces the
you
first
take
winner.
Take out your orange ticket. You're going to win two tickets to
Here
a Sixers
Here we go with the
game.
Second one.
Ticket number 94.
800094. And as our last winner is announced, we are going to head to the commercial break, and we will be back for the second half on LDTV Sports.
The Lenape Regional High School District mobile app is now available for your iOS or Android device. The Lenape District app provides access to a variety of district information at any time, from anywhere. Users can quickly and easily connect with everything from district news, to athletic and activity schedules, to social media, to grades and assignments, in one mobile-friendly view. In the news stream, you can customize what information from which schools you want to follow, and see all of your content all on one page. The calendar feature allows you to choose from activities, clubs, and sports from each of the district high schools so that you only see the events that interest you. And when logged into the app, students and parents can access class schedules, grades, assignments, teacher websites, attendance, and more. The app even allows students and parents to be notified whenever class grades are updated or when a cafeteria balance runs low. Even the district's Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube pages, as well as directories, teacher contact info, resources, and more are all right at your fingertips. The Lenape Regional High School District app is available for free from the App Store and Google Play. Just search Lenape Regional High School District. So get started and download the Lenape Regional High School District app today.
And we are back here at Seneca High School. We are back, ladies and gentlemen, for the second half. Beginning of the third quarter, as we see our score, Shawnee 34, Seneca 9. See this deficit. Seneca's in. We're going to see if they can rekindle and get back into it. Scott, what is the one thing that Seneca can do to even just try to put themselves back into this?
Try to win a quarter. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Try to win a quarter. I mean, you're down, what? I'm not a math guy, but that's 25 points.
Something like 16 or something.
25 points,
right?
Win a quarter. Even if it's 10-9, win a quarter.
Right. And now it is time for the AXA Equitable Sideline Report, providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, be life confident at 732-452-7275. Let's send it over to John Conlow with the report. We will get to John in a little bit as we hear Shawnee, and there it is. Sean Hine will give it to Dean Knoll. Over to Kernan, see that fast passing right back into it. Hine gonna look, oh, nice play. Looked like he was gonna go for the three, threw down the pass, Devaney for three.
You say that looked short.
Kernan right under the basket.
There's another offensive rebound,
another one, you're kidding me.
That's
Dean
four.
Knoll. We'll put it in, and not the start that Seneca wanted.
Yeah, I mean, if you give Shawnee four looks at a basket, they're going to score. There's no doubt about that.
So Scarpello to Brockett, as we see the teams have switched sides. Seneca heading toward the right. Ginyard from the foul line gets the two.
Fifth point of the night for Michael Ginyard. He's the leading scorer for Seneca.
That's Kernan over to Knoll. Lead for the Shawnee Renegades. Back and forth between Kernan and Hine, down to Davon. Sean Hine for three, short again. Davon, man, Kernan is eating up those rebounds so far.
Another offensive rebound. Oh, nice hands by Ginyard to knock that ball away. They had somebody open underneath the basket. Michael Ginyard did a nice job to deflect that ball out of bounds.
Davon, from the corner of the key, gets the easy two.
4 points now for Davon Robinson. Hoey for a long three.
Three for Hoey. Doesn't get it. Hustles back. Kernan over to Knoll. Knoll being pressured well by Dan Kane. Kernan spins around his defender. Hine for three. Doesn't get it. Rebound by Davon. Wow, that unbelievable play. Davon Robinson. Maybe you should call him Davon Rebound. Won't trademark that nickname yet, though. See how the team feels about it. Brockett drives, gives it to Hoey. And that is J.J. Scarpello. Rocket from the foul line, denied by Davon Robinson. Davon Robinson for the drive. Oh, fouled by Scarpello.
Nice job, though, by Scarpello not to give him an easy basket.
Yeah, stay with it.
That is the first team foul of the second half on either squad. He's going to put Davon Robinson in the line to shoot a pair. Davon, 6 points in the game. Missed his only free throw attempt in the first half, so let's see if he can make amends for that.
And he does. Coming in for Seneca is going to be Nigel Kinlaw. And number four, Chris McCauley. Taking a break is going to be Dan Kane and Tom Hoey. Luke Hoey. Davon will make both of them. Brockett.
Lead now up to 29.
Kinlaw's going to drive. Doesn't get that. Tries to get his own rebound.
Nice job by Nigel Kinlaw, though, to keep that alive. give the Golden Eagles a second opportunity.
Brockett for three, doesn't get it. Rebound by Davon Robinson. All right, it's Sean Hine, gives it to Kernan. Kernan highly pressured. Robinson drives, nice little pass to DeVenny. DeVenny works his way into a foul.
Draws a foul on Kinlaw. Should be his third. Yeah. And it is. Second team foul on the Golden Eagles. Going to put Dylan Devaney on the line for a pair.
Gets his first.
So let's see. He shoots well. He passes well. He rebounds well. And he shoots free throws. Huh.
Sounds like the whole package.
I jinxed him. Sorry. Sorry, Dylan. My bad, man.
Brockett gives it to Kinlaw. A little faster passing here in this possession for Seneca. Scarpello drives, and he'll get the hard fought, too.
First basket of the night for JJ.
Knoll to Kernan. To Hine. Hine showing off his height. Knoll, wow, right in. Right off the fingertips.
We get a timeout. I want to comment about the game before this tonight, the JV game. One of the best JV games I've ever seen.
Scarpello not going to be enough. Airballs that one. Kernan will drive, stop, give it to Knoll.
Good defense.
Yeah, nice play by Brockett. Scarpello gives it away.
Nice dish.
Yep, Davon gives it to Hine. Easy two. Davon again with the steal. Little stutter step. Passes it right into the hands of Brockett. DeVenny, nice job hustling down. Brockett.
They're going to call a foul. Two-shot foul.
Okay.
First foul on Dylan Devaney. Brockett goes to the line.
Tough to call there because it looked like his hands were off the ball at the time that DeVenney hit him. That's what the ref saw, so he's got two. Makes the first. Walter Kay coming back in for Scarpello.
Jack Welling waiting to come in, but he's coming in for the shooter. So if Brockett makes the free throw, Welling will come in the game. If not, he'll have to wait till the next stoppage.
All right, Davon Robinson with the rebound.
Brockett 1-for-2 from that time, 2-for-4 for the night.
Kernan over to Hine in the corner for three. He's got the tray. Nice job by Sean Hine. Down low to K.
Oh, nice hook shot by Walter. Good move.
First.
Nice job, big man.
Walter K for
the second basket of the night for Walter K.
Noel drives quick, steps back.
Oh, nice.
Right from the corner of the
key. That's special.
That is a beautiful shot right there. Brockett up top. Walter K's looks like he's hungry. He's going to push off.
And get a foul and a call on Devaney. Quick for second foul. Walter K, an offensive force here the last two possessions. That's a good description. He looked hungry, didn't he? He looked like, give me the ball. It's my time tonight.
In a situation like that where the team's really low and the morale's maybe, you know, not where you want it to be.
It's nice
at one player. Yep. Maybe you're not expecting him. Maybe, you know, maybe he had something to eat, had his Wheaties this morning. There you go. Quick 5 points.
7 points for Walter K, the leading scorer in the game for the Golden Eagles.
Nice. Kernan to Robinson. Robinson thought about it. Then he thought about the score and said, yeah, maybe I'll hold it. Kernan being doubled, leaves DeVenny wide open.
That was a sweet pass. Nice pick and roll there. Sometimes called a screen and roll, whatever you want to call it. But it was well executed and well planned out and well executed.
It's like Najee Kinlaw to pass it in. And Ginyard up top. Nice little move.
Miscommunication there. When things go bad, they go all bad in all aspects. And there's a little miscommunication on the offensive end for Seneca.
He's looking for Jack Welling. Jack Welling, just a sophomore. Kernan to DeVenny. Another one. Oh! Nails the alley-oop. Woo!
That might get us an Ivy rehab replay.
Wow.
Great pass. That's a big man passing that ball, though. That just boggles. And another steal by Davon.
Oh, my gosh. What a show being put on right now. As Sean Hine drives. Nice pass to Dean Noll.
Oh, nice block by Kinlaw.
Yeah, very nice job. Kinlaw stays with it.
I think you'll see Coach Kessler start the fourth with his reserves.
Uh-huh.
Problem with that is they played, many of them JV players played seven quarters earlier today. And another move to the basket by Walter Kay.
Yeah, he's definitely going to want to get DeVenny out right now. Looking at three fouls. Walter Kay, Eaton.
Walter will shoot a pair here. 1 minute exactly remaining in the third quarter.
Over the half, I talked to Shawnee head coach Kessler, and he said they were playing real well last quarter, and they kept moving the ball on offense really well, but they need to start sharing the ball. On defense, their defense was great, but they need to start contesting the shots. So let's see how the rest of the game goes. I'm down on the court. Back to you guys.
All right. Thank you, John. And thank you, AXA Equitable, for that sideline report. AXA Equitable providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, be life confident. Call them at 732-452-7275. Again, thank you, John, and AXA Equitable for that sideline report.
The foul was on Davon Robinson there.
Ginyard from the foul line. He'll get it. Making Shawnee's lead 36 points. Dean Noll showing off a little bit of the ball handling. Oh.
That's a backcourt. Hit off his ankle. Problem you want to avoid here if you're Coach Kessler, obviously this game is in hand. Mm-hmm. I don't see, you're not coming back from 34 down. You don't want to see the team get sloppy because they've got some big games coming up down the road before the playoffs start. You don't want to get any bad habits here tonight.
Wow. Nice drive by Jack Welling. Didn't go in, though. Pat Kernan. Quite the mismatch down low with Sean Hine and Jack Welling. At least height-wise. As we see 10 seconds remaining in this third quarter at Seneca High School. Youth night here in Tabernacle, New Jersey. DeVenny, not going to get that, but gets his rebound.
Nice job, Kinlaw.
Jack Welling isn't going to get that one at the buzzer. So our score at the end of the third quarter is 56-22. Shawnee on top. So, Scott, I don't know if they won the quarter.
They didn't, but they played better. They scored 13 points. They only had 9 in the whole first half. They got 13 in that quarter. So that's a step up and an improvement.
Let's take a look at the Ivy Rehab replay. Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
See if it's Davon's dunk. Oh, yeah. Watch the pass, though. That's what's amazing. Here you go. Nice roll.
Nice Walter roll. K came up to hit hot, or DeVenny.
That's just a sweet pass from DeVenny. A pass you don't see a guy that size make very often, quite frankly. I mean,
big man to big man.
Talking about a 6'6 guy in DeVenny. And Davon's 6'4. So you got a 6'6 guy that can shoot from the outside, pass that well, and only a junior. The only senior that we've seen tonight is, as you call him, Gronk.
Yep. Him and Robbie Steffen. That's a really impressive.
Robbie Steffen, you're right. We did see Robbie
in
the game. Yes,
that's the really impressive thing about this Shawnee basketball team. We've said a lot about him, but so impressive how all of their starters are going to be coming back next year. Shows a lot for the future.
Now we have another senior in, Sam McNellis, 25. Connor Devaney, the younger brother. 22 is Robbie Steffen. He's in the game. The Gronk is back in and looks like Kane Feudner. Did I see him out there?
Yes. Yes, there he is, number 14.
Golden Eagles will have Scarpello, Ginyard, Kinlaw, Walter Kay, and Jack Brockett. Their starters back in the fourth quarter.
8 minutes to go here at Seneca High School.
And I don't think you'll see any of the Shawnee starters back in tonight.
Sam McNell's playing on Brockett. There's Ginyard. Walter Kay being played by Gronk.
They're going to call offensive on Walter this time.
Gronk
taking
the charge. Look at that little Gronk smile he's got. Connor Devaney to pass it in. Passes to Gronk. Gives it to Sam McNellis. Kane Feudner with the ball. And a foul looks to be...
probably Walter Kay on the reach.
Should be number 40, Walter Kay.
That'll be his second.
Kane Feudner will pass it into Robbie Steffen. Steffen to Garasino. McNellis. Steal by Brockett. Ball's going to be rolling. Didn't help him out much there yet. That'll be a foul by Kane Feudner. Ball was rolling a little too fast for Brockett. Definitely wasn't intentional by Feudner. But it's just the way the feet got caught up.
Second personal foul on Feudner.
Not sure about that pass looking for Kinlaw. But that's Feudner to McNellis. Steffen for three. Not going to get it. Wow, what a rebound. Looking good work by Kane Feudner to reach over. Walter Kay looked like he was.
Possession will go to Shawnee.
Walter Kay looked like he was going to get it. Perfect position to do it. But Feudner just came swooping in. Feudner in the corner gives it to Garasino. Steffen looks for Feudner. Feudner for three. He's got the tray.
Well, nobody came to pick him up. You know, he kind of mishandled the ball a little bit. No defender rushed at him, and he just said, there's nobody here, I'll shoot it.
Walter Kay, good work down there. There's Ginyard for three. Not going to get it. Rebound by Brockett. Gets hit in the back by Feudner.
Should be his third.
Be two shots.
Foul.
Two shots for Jack Brockett.
He's gone one of two each time he's been to the line. This is his third time at the line tonight.
Coming in for Seneca is going to be Thomas Jeanson. In
for Walter Kay.
Yeah, Walter Kay.
And one for two again. Nice rebound by Kinlaw, and we've got a foul.
Another one. Kinlaw gets fouled. Looks to be either Feudner, could be Feudner or Garasino. It's going to be Garasino. That'll be his first of the night.
And put Shawnee over the limit now with seven, so Seneca will be in the bonus. Doesn't apply this time as Nyjie Kinlaw looks to get his first points of the evening. Been held scoreless tonight. Makes the first.
Coming in is going to be Luke Hoey.
For J.J. Scarpello.
Kinlaw trying for his second. Doesn't get it. Futner with the rebound. Futner with a head full of steam. Sam McNellis for three. In and out.
Solid rebound by Ginyard.
Yep.
One of their better rebounds tonight. Good position. Went up and got the ball and said, nobody's getting this from me. Wild shot there.
Yeah. Rebound again by Futner. McNellis to Garasino. Running the basket. Nice pass from Futner. No look.
Ooh, almost a walk there. Oh, nice move.
Stephen will drive and get fouled. Draw the foul on Brock.
Second foul on Brockett. Should be the 15th foul against Seneca. Robbie Stephan to the line to shoot a pair. Makes the first. Here comes Tommy Fox, 24. Chris McCauley back in, number 4. And Jack Welling stepping in, number 13. So it looks like the starters for Coach Kenevin's team are going to have the rest of the night off as well.
Stephan will get it. McCauley gives it to Hoey, to Jeanson, right in the key. Not going to get that, too. That was Tommy Fox. Robbie Stephan nails the tray. Chris McCauley. Up top is going to be Jack Welling. Welling, nice pass there. Could have been a walk, but he got away with it. Nice pass. Jack Welling. Welling gives it to McCauley. McCauley for three. Not going to get it. Kane Futner. 5 minutes remaining in this game here at Seneca High School. Devaney for three. Not going to get it. Travis Garasino gives it to Robbie Stephan. Stephan gets the two. Nice signs from the senior Robbie Stephan. Chris McCauley gives it to Thomas Jeanson. Jeanson over to Hoey. McCauley dribbling, waiting for something. McCauley drives, passes it right to Sam McNellis. Devaney down to Stephan. Stephan drives. Nice looking hook shot. Dr. J action a little bit. There's McCauley. And McCauley's got it on the far side. Tommy Fox gives it to Hoey. Hoey drives, pushes. Doesn't get the hard fought two. A rebound by McNellis. McNellis to Stephan. Devaney. Travis Garasino. Robbie Stephan over to Kane Futner. Futner drives, gets the two. To put Shawnee up by 44 points. Long three, hits off the side of the backboard. That was Tommy Fox going for that one. All new faces coming in for Shawnee.
Yeah, Coach Kessler calls a timeout to make the swap. Oh, talking about the JV game before, you know, before we come on air. And what a game. We were both here, Jimmy. Four overtimes.
Unbelievable.
Or three overtimes.
Three.
Three overtimes.
Still outrageous.
Just an outrageous game. One of the best JV games I've ever seen. Back and forth. Each team had chances to win. Just a great game. Some of these guys you see out there now were in that great game.
Connor Devaney. nails the tray. But yes, Scott, as you were saying, unbelievable JV game. They play him right before the varsity games. Nice roller three for Jack Welling. See, most of these JV players on for Shawnee now. That's Ryan High, number three. Drew Brennan.
I'm guessing Ryan must be the younger brother of Sean.
Yes. Tell the
tremendous grasp of the obvious, don't I?
Yeah.
And there's a three ball knockdown again.
Looks like Drew Brennan nails the tray.
And he had a great game in the JV contest, too.
Yes.
McCauley. Yeah. Chris McCauley with a nice bucket there.
Connor DeVenny.
2 minutes left here tonight in what has been a dominant performance by the Renegades here this evening.
Really what they needed after that loss to Lenape. Seneca could have used something, had a lot of momentum going into the game with the Chicago Bulls-esque entrance.
Great atmosphere tonight, right. No matter what the final score was. This is just great to see for Seneca basketball. Not the outcome they wanted, but you know, you're up against one of the best teams in not only South Jersey, but the entire state. So nice solid rebound there by Connor Devaney.
Drives. He'll get the roller. And nice to see this Shawnee bench cheering on JV players.
We apologize, we don't have number one on our roster, so we apologize for not being able to tell you his name.
Ryan Hine.
Nice finish by the Golden Eagles there.
Nice shot from Connor DeVenny. And he will nail the tray. Tommy Fox, no shot, push.
Looks like we're going to have a foul on the floor, so it'll be 1-1 for Fox. Tommy Fox at the line to shoot a pair for the Golden Eagles with
43 seconds to go. Tommy Fox.
Oh, I see. I knew he was going to make the first one. That's why I said he was going to shoot a pair. I'm like Nostradamus over here. See if Tommy Fox can knock down the second one.
And
ooh, with a little roll, it's good.
Ryan Hine. Gonna bring it down court. Hine will give it to Brennan. Hine keeps it. Okay, there's Ryan Hine. He'll give it to DeVenny.
Shawnee just willing to pass the ball around now. That's, you know, Coach Kessler. He's got enough. Seneca doing a nice job trying to trap without fouling. See if they can get a turnover here in the last five. And that'll be Hine over there in the corner. He's trapped in the corner. And that's the end of the ball game.
That is the end of tonight's game with the final score, Shawnee 79, Seneca 33.
Big quarter for the Renegades, 23 points there in the fourth quarter. See the players shaking hands, and while they shake hands, this would be a perfect time for my man Jimmy Freeze to read the crew list and thank everybody that helped us out tonight.
All right, we are going to thank Walter Klaus, Owen Volkrich, Sean Herb, Josh Gladstone, Shan Kazangian, Kanan Lidowy, Timothy Durkis, Anna Olson, Ryan Thomas, Adam Feltoon, and our sideline reporter John Conlow, and your broadcasters here, Scott Glossner being the beauty, and me, Jimmy Freeze, being the brawn.
I thought you were going to say the beast.
Well, either one. And there that's our final score here at Shawnee High School, 79, That will make Shawnee 16-2, and 33 will make Seneca 7-12. No matter the outcome, as I said at the halftime with the skills challenge, we just tried, and the momentum was here for Seneca. As you said, Scott, a tough team to face.
Well, and they jumped out early. I mean, they jumped out the 10-0 run for Shawnee right away, and that kind of killed, I don't say killed, it certainly deflated the big crowd that we had here tonight for Seneca.
And we will be back, ladies and gentlemen, for our play and player of the game.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990, www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market, all the best, all right here. 215-336-3003, or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Wilmore School of Gymnastics and Cheer, where every child is special. Located on Briggs Road in Mount Laurel. 856-234-5292. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. And by Heads Up, Eyes Forward, please never drive distracted. www.lrhsd.org/heads-up. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680, or by email, jmalagrana@lrhsd.org.
We're back here at Seneca High School. We just finished this game up, with our final score being 79-33, Shawnee. You see the crew, everybody cleaning up the court. Everybody had a piece in this game tonight for Shawnee. And even the fans, you know, pre-game stuff. Scott, you even broadcast, announced to the crowd at halftime.
It was fun. It was a really, really fun night here.
And it is now time for the Reconstructive Orthopedics Player of the Game at 1-800-896-RECON or on the web at www.reconstructiveortho.com. Let's send it over to John Conlow and Dean Knoll, standing by for the interview.
Thanks, guys. I'm with the player of the game, Dean Knoll, who had 17 shots for Shawnee. So, Dean, what was the key to such great offense tonight?
I'd say being unselfish, making an extra pass, and knocking down our shots.
So this weekend you have a tournament and you have a game back at Shawnee this Tuesday. What is your plan for the end of the regular season and for playoffs?
I would say keep working hard, getting better and better every game. For playoffs.
All right, thanks. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Back to you guys.
Nice job by John Conlow to talk to Dean. And Dean, you know, it's just the typical unselfishness. Our nothing personal goals, all team-oriented goals.
It brings that speed and that defense, even the offense of a point guard. Reminds me a lot of Chris Paul. Terrific job by Dean Knoll. We'll definitely try to pursue that basketball career. It is now time to take a look at the Allstate Good Hands Play of the Game, sponsored by Michael McDyer, CLTC, at 609-654-1426, or michaelmcdyer@allstate.com. Allstate, you're in good hands.
Well, I can only guess what this is. Here's Devinny out front. Nice roll by Davon Robinson.
Oh,
beautiful
Lord.
Blast. Right above the rim, Davon jams it home.
Ironically, number 23 jams it home for the W. And that will conclude our broadcast tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us here on LDTV. Scott Glossner and Jimmy Freeze. We're going to check out our productions, actually, right now. You can check out our productions. You can LDTV Sports productions are available online at youtube.com/LenapeeDistrictTV. And to purchase a copy of tonight's show, you can go to www.lrhsd.org/LDTV copies. And our next game is going to be the basketball playoffs. Those are a little undecided right now, so you can check out all the schedule and check out even the spring schedule coming out soon for LDTV Sports on the website.
This is our last regular season game in the winter season. Next time we see you here on LDTV, it'll be playoff basketball time.
And that will do it here, ladies and gentlemen, for our broadcast tonight on LDTV Sports. From Scott Glossner and Jimmy Freeze, thank you very much. That's our final score. Have a good night.
This program was produced by Lenape District Television.
Do you have a plan to increase security in places like that?
The district has up-to-date and well-tested emergency response plans.